in the Garden of Eden. Could these stories about otherworldly serpent beings able to influence humanity have any substance? If they have been part of human history for thousands of years, where did they come from? Are they alien creatures coming to Earth from another planet? Or what if they were living right under our feet?
Earth's first fighters.
A lot of juggling for position, kind of like boxers will do before they start the fight.
Don't know how this works. Fancy any comments? Somebody's there. Say hello, sir. So. See if it pops up. Hi, Josh. Hey, Tracy Ann. So that's how it works. How are yous? She's my first live on YouTube. Hey David, how are you, Zong? Don't know what Deb says. I messaged her, but she's not. Get back to her. Was she? So she might be still be sleeping then.
Equal eye. You make me sick. I
Don't know how she can stay up so late. I'm normally in my bed for half 8, 9. Eric! How are ya? Ooh, nice. What did you have? I just had leftover Domino's from last night. Well, it's dinner time here. It's weird, your comments come up and then they disappear. Is that normal? I've never done this before. There we go, back.
Los Angeles, California, in January 1934. The Los Angeles Times published an article entitled Lizard People's Catacomb City Haunted, describing the attempt by mining engineer G. Warren Schufelt to find and excavate a maze of tunnels which he believed were beneath the streets of downtown Los Angeles. Warren Schufelt was a mining engineer, and he invented a device that he called radio X-ray to be used for gold mining, and this device could find tunnels underground, and he actually created a map of the tunnels. Included on Schufelt's map of tunnels were 16 places where he said he had located gold deposits.
You get there, Brian.
Gained momentum after meeting with a Hopi medicine man who told him the legend of the lizard people that lived in underground cities. Warren Schufelt had a sit-down with an Indian medicine man in Arizona who told him there was a Gopi legend.
Somebody message her.
There was three cities on the Pacific coast that were completely underground. The story goes...
Wake up.
And these lizard people sought refuge underground, but they dug these tunnels. And one of the network of tunnels was under the city of Los Angeles.
Thank you.
According to the legend, the lizard people carved out vast chambers large enough to house 1,000 families.
I messaged her, but
using advanced technologies,
maybe nothing.
Chemical that could easily bore through bedrock. Schufelt obtained permission from the city and began digging to try and find the tunnel system. The city council, perhaps motivated by the alleged gold that was contained within the tunnels, allowed Schufelt to dig a 250-foot shaft on condition that he would give them 50% of any treasure recovered. Warren Schufelt was a successful mining engineer, and it seems that he had some kind of connection to Los Angeles.
So I already done the outline the other day, because that takes ages, and then I can just get right into it.
So now we have these stories of underground people, race living underground, and tunnels and bases.
What time is it? Where you are?
Kind of reptilian extraterrestrials who have taken control of our planet and are living underground. It seems incredible, and yet it's what some of the stories are telling us. Imagine an advanced race of lizard people had once lived underneath the west coast of America.
Still very early.
Interestingly, a nearly identical legend exists nearly halfway around the world. Benares, in India.
Tracy, you in the UK?
Within this city lies the Well of Sheshna, which in Hindu legend is an entrance into an underground city of the Nagas. A race of semi-divine serpent people known throughout Eastern culture.
In Benares, the sacred city of India, there is a well of Sheshna.
Nice. Merseyside, is that in Newcastle?
Mystery and some danger, and only the holy can make contact with it.
Patala is the underworld in Hindu mythology. There are many beings that live in there, many reptilians, which are called Nagas. As a demigod, they must have descended from heaven to the earth to teach, to give special qualities to the human world.
Ancient astronaut theorists claim the Hindu stories of the Nagas bear a striking resemblance to the Hopi stories of lizard people who also reportedly live beneath the earth.
The Snapchat filters you're talking about.
The Naga, the serpent beings, but the reptilian beings of the Hopi tradition, we see a common thread here of these beings who were at one time reviled and also revered, but also as beings that have a direct influence on humanity.
Is it merely coincidence that extremely similar legends of advanced reptilian beings living underground can be found on opposite sides of the world? And is it possible these reptilians...
Does anybody watch Ancient Aliens on History?
...surface every so often to interact with humanity?
I'm addicted to it.
Perhaps some clues can be found in artifacts on Earth in the cradle of civilization. Southern Iraq in 1923. British archaeologist Sir Leonard Woolley led an excavation to uncover the remains of one of the oldest agricultural communities in the world. The Ubaid culture.
What, the Drax one?
To 5900 BC.
Do you want to see what I'm drawing? Because that just looks ridiculous.
Among the dwellings and tools, they also discovered these strange-looking clay figurines.
Oh.
I say strange because they don't really look human. They have the facial features of what seems to be reptiles. Now, is it possible that the Sumerians were depicting a race of beings that were living among...
It's Galen, my auntie's dog, that... get put to sleep.
Mainstream scholars have debated the meaning of the statues since their discovery, thinking perhaps they were Sumerian gods. Ancient astronaut theorists, however, believe the statues could have a different meaning.
These clay figurines have these what are called coffee bean eyes, they have these elongated skulls. They look very much like some kind of reptilian extraterrestrial. And they're breastfeeding children and doing very normal human things that you wouldn't think that gods would necessarily be doing.
So that's okay, he was an old boy.
Of human activity with...
It's like 12.
Reptilian aliens.
Normally in huskies their hips and that go, and he couldn't even stand up. So it was time. His hips went and he couldn't stand up and he ended up being like incontinent. He was just having a really bad time and it got worse and worse and worse, and then they decided that it was best that they put him down. He had a good life, but he lived in a boat most of it, for most of it, in America. And then over to the Bahamas and sailed about the Bahamas, all the islands. the Virgin Isles, Grand Bahama, Nassau, Kirks and Caicos? No, I don't know how to say that. And then they moved to the Dominican Republic and started building a house. I lived in a boat for about a year or two. Maybe it was 2.5 years, and then they started building the house, and then they moved into the house. Eric, I've always kind of drew, but I never really started to draw him properly till about 2011. Then I started taking it more serious. And I've done 4 years at college. I've done an illustration course. Then I went to another college and I've done an advanced higher in fine art. Then I done an NC in fine art. That's actually 5 years, actually. And then I done a HNC in contemporary art, and then a HND in contemporary art. But they didn't really teach you how to draw, it was just a load of rubbish. Contemporary rubbish. You could draw a squiggle on a bit of paper, but yeah, yeah, it's contemporary. All the bollocks. The colour books are really good. I keep buying them, but I never get round to calling them in.
At the National Museum of Canada, paleontologist and curator of vertebrate fossils,
Dan Russell published a thought experiment based on the trend toward larger brain sizes.
It's not really exciting watching somebody draw, is it? It's like watching paint dry.
About what one species of dinosaur would have evolved into if it had survived the mass extinction 65 million years ago. What he did is take the dinosaur known as Trudon. They noticed the morphological changes in the skeletal structure of the dinosaur, and based on over time where it was going, they extrapolated it out further. And strangely enough, or wonderfully enough, they actually came up with a model that resembled a humanoid reptilian being, which actually matched that of the reports that we were hearing now, as well as reports from ancient history.
That's true, Tracy. I know, I watch videos of people drawing all the time, and I just love it. Well, maybe, I don't know if it's because I do it myself, but I could sit and watch it all the time.
Imagine reptilians that could be the descendants of dinosaurs that walked the Earth millions of years ago.
Our concept of dinosaurs is changing all the time, of course, and nowadays we're making so many new discoveries every year that we're reinterpreting them in many ways. Certainly, if you look 20, 30 years back, there were so many things that have been found and so many other things we know now. Particularly, I think it's been very important that nowadays is completely very well accepted the idea that dinosaurs are not extinct. The dinosaurs essentially evolved into birds and that they're alive today.
And now that we know that not all the dinosaurs died out, as a matter of fact, some survived to become birds.
Don't know what to chat about with these, what to chat about.
Dinosaur, which is considered reptile and cold-blooded. We're recognizing,
I've been on here for 23 minutes already.
We recognize them now as being part of the dinosaur family. What could these other pockets that had survived the devastation 65 million years ago, could they have evolved parallel to mankind in hidden cavern systems? And could they be actually the beings that we think are extraterrestrial, but are actually our terrestrial neighbors?
Paleontologists generally argue that the dinosaurs died out totally 65 million years ago. I think it's certainly within the realm of feasibility that some found an ecological niche to survive in and may even exist today. And I point out that while we hear UFO abductees talking about little grays and tall humanoids, a minority of them do report encounters with what we would call reptoids.
Yeah, I gave him a bath and then a bottle and then he went, fell asleep pretty rapid. Hey, Courtney. How are you?
For experiments they were doing with new species they were trying to engineer. Maybe they manipulated dinosaur DNA to favor certain mutations. By playing with certain mutations in the genes of dinosaurs, highly advanced extraterrestrials through genetic modification may have been able to alter the course of dinosaur evolution to favor the rise of mammals.
Why would space travelers manipulate the DNA of reptiles and mammals?
The joys.
As ancient astronaut theorists believe.
experiments have resulted in a reptilian human hybrid species that lives underground.
We made it, I don't remember, you just decided to write and it's tidied.
We really don't know the full record of dinosaurs on our planet, since dinosaurs were here for millions of years. Many of these references to a current reptilian race or an ancient serpent race that was worshipped by various cultures could be an offshoot, a genetic variation of dinosaurs that naturally evolved here on Earth.
If extraterrestrials had somehow assisted the evolution of reptiles as well as human beings, perhaps there could have been some mixing of reptile and human genes. Some say we need look no further than our own bodies. Punjab, in India, 2001. A boy named Balaji was born with a bizarre deformity. A 7-inch tail. Believing his tail to be a sign of divinity, people began flocking to his house, offering prayers, money, and gifts, hoping their wishes would be fulfilled in return.
Oh, that's nice, Eric.
But he had a weird serpent-like tail at the base of his spine. And the reason why he was being worshipped was that
I liked it as well. Really enjoyed doing it.
With tails like this. And they thought that he was the reincarnated form of one of the gods.
Over 100 cases of human tails have been reported in medical journals since the 1800s. Every human embryo has a small tail in the early stages of development, which is usually reabsorbed by the growing body by 9 weeks of pregnancy.
Similarities in the developmental stages of embryos of animals have been observed for a very long time.
Yeah, Jon Snow. I love him.
Species often have,
yeah, Game of Thrones fan.
Essentially identical. And then it's not until later in development that they start to develop some of their characteristics that sort of uniquely define the different species. And in fact, our own embryos have a tail, for instance, and look very much like embryos of other vertebrate animals if we go, you know, really, really early into our development.
If you go back far enough, humans and reptiles share a common ancestor. If you go back about 300 million years before present, you find this group that's evolving where one line went off towards the what's now the reptiles and lizards. And
winter is coming. Really? Your mom sounds cool then.
We grew up thinking that, you know, reptiles were the closest relative.
Do you stay with your mom? Does she help you out? Oh, I know, Tracy. Is it beaut? Dying for the next series to come out.
In addition to humans born with tails, there are other genetic conditions that some say could suggest a link with our reptilian past. People with the disease ichthyosis have dry, scaly skin. And people with the diseases called syndactyly and extradactyly have fused fingers and claw-like hands. There's even a biblical legend that people who lived before the patriarch Noah had webbed fingers.
Legend says that until the time of Noah,
I wonder who's going to be the king of the throne. Is it going to be Danny? Is it going to be John? Or is it going to be somebody totally unexpected? Hope it is John. He's my favourite.
There are traditions in numerous cultures of reptilian bloodlines associated with royalty. According to legend, Alexander the Great was sired by a dragon,
Can you hear banging?
Japanese legend, state the founder of the imperial dynasty, Jimmu, was the great. Just having a dragon like appearance.
Stop soon as I paused it.
Is it possible these ancient rulers?
I think my neighbours are having a party. I've got one of these bands.
The royal bloodline issue is one of which they believe that the heredity of certain individuals carried some form of a unique signature in their blood that is bestowed upon them by ancient reptilian human beings. So let's ask this question. Why, throughout known human history, there have been certain families and bloodlines that have claimed to be superior?
Yeah, Stebs. She gave me it when I met her to give her the Drax. Drone. Sorry, I keep yawning. I'm so tired.
Claim the right to rule because of their alleged descendants from the serpent gods. Why did the kings of Media now?
Yeah.
Why were they called
so good.
The Dragon Dynasty?
I don't drink Rockstar, by the way, I drink
constant theme unfolding all the way through history. Might the stories of rulers with reptilian bloodlines be in any way true? Some say it's possible that all humans have a genetic connection to reptilian ancestors. And think that clues can be found very deep in our brains.
Can you hear my telly? You must be thinking, what am I watching?
It's as though someone is trying to erase this man from history. I don't know what's in those documents. I don't know where the documents are that we don't know about. This is a patent for his death.
It's about ancient aliens. Does anybody believe in aliens? Is it just, is it copyright with just music or is it with telly programmes as well?
Stronger?
Well, yeah.
But yeah, I
I know. She does. She could use a laptop. Her new shiny laptop. I love getting a new laptop, it's the best feeling ever. Dibs! Are you in a boot? Is that why? So I'll chip in and get Deborah a new phone.
Carl Sagan published his Pulitzer Prize winning book, Dragons of Eden. Speculations on the evolution of human intelligence.
You're flappy.
The book explores the theory put forth by neuroscientist Paul McLean, which connects parts of the brain to different time periods in history.
Paul McLean suggested that the forebrain itself could actually be subdivided into three different parts. One of which he called the reptilian complex, the other he called the paleomammalian complex, or later was referred to as the limbic system, and the third he called the neomammalian complex. This was significant.
I like Flappy better.
These three different aspects of the forebrain to
my laptop is pretty good until my boyfriend got drunk and flung it across the room and spilt a full pint of beer on it. He thinks I don't know that he flung it across the room, but I came in and he was mad with it. And there was a full pint over the laptop, and the laptop was pure way over the other side. Emoji. Gay.
If they want sex, they would just rape the person. There'd be no higher order thought at all. Carl Sagan suggested that we need to actually focus on the reptilian brain because that's where these primitive urges of aggression
you've been up to. Table type.
Is it possible that the reptilian aspect of our brains, along with rare human anomalies, like
I'm confused. I'm drawing a husky.
And fused fingers might be the result of something other than our evolution from prehistoric reptiles. Some suggest
it's a cutie pie. Look at those eyes. Ooh.
Describing human-like entities with reptilian characteristics. Nag Hammadi, Egypt, December 1945.
Still time. We've extended the competition, so if you want to get a drawing done, then you need to comment on one of Debs's live videos. Don't be shy.
Secret gospels. Mixed in with the religious writings are poems, instructions for mystical practice, and a description of the
got two really good ideas already.
That shed a great deal of light on early religious issues, biblical texts, and biblical history. But they made a mention of a very mysterious race of creatures that have become known as the Archons.
You getting there a wee back rub? Rubbing her feet. You wouldn't even rub my feet.
What's interesting shocking is that there is actually a depiction and a description of the Archons looking definitively reptilian.
What did you do to your back, Linnell?
So this has given rise to the idea that perhaps the reptilians, the Archons, one and the same.
They're very robot-like, very machine-like, and therefore very predictable. And given that you see the machine-like nature of so many reptilian animals
had Domino's for my dinner last night and then I had the leftovers for my dinner the night.
An expression of this machine-like, unemotional, computer-like mentality.
You need to carry your charger about with you.
Is believed to be responsible for our most aggressive...
The big hairy... big foot feet. Curly toes, hair. No, I don't like people touching my feet either.
And you'll find similar stories on a similar theme. It seems to be talking about when humans were created.
We'll get a shot of Linnell's phone.
I would strongly suggest that actually it's not talking about that at all. It's talking about the point when human genetics were interfered with.
Debs, you're meant to be their helpers. You should be cooking her a nice dinner. Sounds easily.
Fusion, I would suggest, of what I would call archon genetics, symbolically the serpent in the Garden of Eden.
Oh, that's nice.
The argument that the being that approached.
And then did you go for a Kepner couch? Because I heard you were up to 6 this morning.
A reptilian.
On Twitch.
The suggestion is that the whole idea of the Garden of Eden was nothing else but some type of a lab that was run by extraterrestrials in which we were ultimately created. Now, this sounds absolutely insane, and I'm aware of how this sounds. But if you look into the whole story, along with all the other supporting accounts, then if you are of the same mindset, you could potentially come to the same conclusion. What if human beings really were the product of genetic manipulation by extraterrestrial visitors? And our ancestors were some form of reptilian human.
What is it? Torture, doing hair. Dog hair.
Wes Henry locked up in his bedroom, feeling paralyzed and icy cold. He saw what he described as a horrible creature across the room. Green, hairless, extremely muscular, and with red glowing eyes. Wes was terrified until the creature disappeared.
I can't believe that's 45 minutes I've been on here. It's fluent.
Individuals who claim to have had contact not with the small, diminutive little gray beings or the Nordic blondes from the 50s, these were quite different. These were reptilian humanoid beings. In other words, humanoid beings that had reptilian physiology to their outer appearance. And they started showing up in some of the shadows of some of the more reliable cases that I was investigating.
I'm aware of a number of cases where people have woken up in the middle of the night, sort of frozen in bed, unable to move, and seen these 7 to 8 feet tall reptilian-type creatures just hovering over them. And each and every person has reported on this.
You're a good lass, Deborah. It's a cotton bud or a Q-tip if you're in the US of A. I've got proper blending stumps and all the fancy jazz for doing stuff like this, but it kind of beat a Q-tip. And I'm lazy.
offer any evidence of reptilian ancestors. If they exist, what could they want?
The reptilian agenda is very simple. They are seeking to hijack life on Earth to over now thousands of years and more. Infiltrate human society to change it into their image.
What did you tissues? You can use it, really. You could use paintbrushes, Q-tips, sponge. Paper's not great for shading. You could use your finger, but that leaves like oily traces on the paper. And cloth, I suppose, but depends what kind of shade you're going for. Or like makeup pad things, like big cotton pads. Okay, see you later, Josh. Thanks for stopping by. But you can buy like a million different types of stuff for blending, but this works just as good. These aren't good, but if you need to get into like a tiny wee bit and not smudge like a bigger bit, it's where the blending stumps come in, because they're like pencil shaped and you can just like peel them off, or you can sharpen them. But so what I was thinking about with this drawing, right, he stops, his ears come to about here. It's nearly halfway. And I've got another drawing. Yeah, another photo. I'm just going to put another one up here. He's like looking forward this way, and then the one up the top, he's like, it's a side view. I think it would look cool. So normally, I'm just going to rabble shite, right? Oh, excuse my language. With this, all the darker bits, I normally like to put like a shade in and then give you a basic line. So when it comes to putting your pencil down on top of it, you've kind of got a first layer and it rubs out your pencil marks from getting the drawing down on the paper. And also, if it's not really dark, and if it's not really a dark place, and you don't want to use a pencil, you can just use your stump. Get another bit of paper. Make a wee patch. And then you can use that like a palette. And then that gives you more pencil, instead of putting any pencil on the paper and then blending it. You can use it like a paintbrush. sometimes pencils go really shiny, like if the darker you use it, and also that helps to take the shine off the pencil. I think you can get like shiny free. Oh man, God. Shiny free pencils. I don't know. Like they're made of carbon, but. Starting to take a wee bit of shape. So the two ideas that we've got for the in school, I was alright. I wasn't really. I don't know. I don't think I had the attention span in school for anything. So, I don't know. I could have been really good in school if I tried. And then the school binned my portfolios. I don't even know. Can't even remember half the stuff that I done in school. But I wish I had that. Would have been good. In fact, for the most of my third year of school in high school, I was never there, but I only went in for two classes, and that was art and English. Summer 1998, in the harsh badlands of northwestern South Dakota, a group of amateur paleontologists are conducting a routine dig when they make a stunning discovery. They have stumbled upon a prehistoric crime scene. They were immediately able to determine that the remains belonged to a young T. Rex. But this was not just an ordinary skeleton. Many of the bones had been broken, and surrounding the skeleton were strange. My storybook. But these teeth were not the teeth of the baby T. Rex. Oh, your storybook? Yeah, go for it. You wrote a story or stories? In 1998, near the town of Belle Fouche, South Dakota, they found what appeared to be the skeletal remains of a relatively small dinosaur. At first, they weren't sure what they had, but the evidence started to emerge that told them this was a young Tyrannosaurus rex. T. Rex is a pretty rare dinosaur. The juveniles are almost unheard of, so its discovery was pretty significant. Debs, if you're there, I've altered you something on Amazon. I think it will make your life a lot easier for what you do. Will that be cool? Yeah, send it. I'll show you what I've ordered you. one of these. It's for your phone, and you can put a camera in there. It's got a wee spirit level on everything, so you're on the same level and that. You can have it pointing up that way to your bike. Aye, so. And these legs extend as well. You can go to like that short, you can have it that long, or extend it. And obviously that moves for however big or small your phone is, or your camera. Nae bora, Debs. Cheers, Eric. It's Salvador Dali. It's hard to show you. None of your business. How rude, Deborah. It's a present. Sorry, I pressed the off button there. Cheers. Thank you very much, David. Right, see this bloody YouTube live? It's... I got you. I ordered it. It's saying rotate. Can't remember when it's going to be here, but I'll check and I'll let you know. So what kind of pizzas did you get? I got a chicken supreme, half and half chicken supreme and a veggie supreme last night. I had like a quarter left and then Ryan had like a quarter left, so I just ate that from a dinner. Praying it doesn't give me heartburn.
studying its environment, step two of the investigation was to study the
behavior. Ah, mas mesmo está frustrado, não? Sug it. What? No mushrooms? That's despicable. Mushrooms are my favourite thing on this planet. Eat them raw. I don't know, can you do that when you're pregnant? Better not. Oh, is she yo-yoing? Yo-yo. Did you see the picture I'm drawing, Debs? Cat butt cookies. Lila. Support the idea that T-Rex lived in family group was made in Montana. Paleontologists discovered the remains of several individuals that suggested that this was a family of Tyrannosaurus rexes. Because this is a tripod sitting on her seat, she's not in a good mood. Linnell is Deborah in disguise. That's her nighttime name. Oh, sorry, her during the day name. At nighttime she goes by Debs. During the day she's Linnell. Yeah, by the way, how dear is Domino's, right? Went to get two pizzas last night and it came to £40. Just as well I had a 50% code. I spy with my own eye something beginning with. Now I'm watching something about dinosaurs. Ancient Aliens is done. I have no idea, Deborah. I don't know what I'm doing. I've just realised I can get the comments to come back if I touch the screen, which I didn't know I could do. Hold on. Live chat. I'm on top chat now. What should I be on? I don't know. Right, live chat. Yeah, that's what I was on.
tickets only for customers from compared to market. Simple.
Adagos of different event is on. And save 20% on furniture with thousands of wines included. Plus, clean up with these Dyson vacuums, just $199.99 each. And with the Argos card, you can take up to 12 months to pay when you spend £199 or more on selected indoor furniture and floor care. Plus, save £30 on a Samsung Tab A 10-inch tablet with free McAfee total protection, just £169. With Argos, you're good to go.
Morning, Churchy. What's the plan for today?
If your car is vandalized, Churchill will let you keep your motorist discount.
That'd have been embarrassing! Oh, yes!
Churchill, depend on the dog.
Okay, Google. Do I look nice?
You're a 10 out of 10.
You too, baby. You too. Dulux Easy Care with hardware and formula stays the way you painted it.
Brighten up your home this back holiday. Well, at B&Q, get any 5-litre Dulux Standard Coloured Emulsion for just £20. In fact, we've got low prices across our paint range. You can do it when you're B&Q.
If you spit blood, you may have gum disease and could be on a journey to much worse. Help stop the journey of gum disease. Switch to Corsodil toothpaste. It's 4 times more effective at removing the main cause of bleeding gums. For healthy gums and strong teeth, help leave bleeding gums behind. Corsodil Ultra Clean.
Gum protection. Right, I think I'll go in 5 minutes because it's... bore the pants off you, so I don't have anything to do what you say.
Sandy. So we've had a severe leak. Parents en route, and time is running out. Lucky for you, they've called Direct Line. Your plumber's been, so let's put this plan into action.
But thanks for all joining me in that.
Mango, Big Will's on dry up. Kumquat, Agatha's on the heavy stuff. Are we Crystal?
Yeah.
It's been bra. Linnell, I hope your back gets better and enjoy your pizza. Look at the state of my living room. It's turned into a toy shop. I was like, I'll just bring all your toys in here, Aiden, even though you can't even sit up really yourself or be anything. And I'll... It's a bloody mess. But that's it so far.
That was just the right thing to do. 200 years later, TSB partners still believe that helping local people and their communities is...
If you want more, give us a shout.
At Argos, treat yourself with free vouchers. £10 when you spend 100 or £5 when you spend 50. With Argos, you're good to go.
Back again. What are you... You're just charging your phone for like a percent and then typing and then it's dying and then charging, typing, dying, charging, typing, dying. Should get one of the power bank battery things. I'll just get a new phone. Jesus. Did you send me that book?
The discovery of a juvenile Tyrannosaurus Rex with numerous broken necks and arms.
Right, I'm gonna go. Can't I stop yawning? Are you taking notes? Come join me, Al. I'll teach you how to draw.
Basically, that's just a jack
scrape my hair back. Right. Tie bye. How do you get out of this? Am I stuck in here forever? I don't know how.